being a volunteer here, preferably from the invitees or the audience. So I would be doing a little bit of fortune telling here, inspired by the video. No, actually it was a part of my talk earlier also. So the little bit of fortune telling includes a person whose nickname is Bunty. Who's Bunty here? You can raise your hand. Okay, come up. Bunty. There are two Bunty walking in there.
None of them is Bunty.
Quick, quick. Okay, so we have Bunty here. Bunty, do I know you?
Yes.
Okay. And do you know me?
Yes.
How many times have we interacted on phone or your hobbies or about you, your life?
You've interacted with me like 15 minutes back.
So, other than that, what do I know about you? Okay. So, if I am wrong, tell me that right now we all can understand her body language. She's a little bit of nervousness. She's feeling okay. Now she is handheld behind her back. So a little bit of confidence, at least what you're projecting. So tell me if I'm wrong. You have been hiding something from the society or your entire world. There's one thing that you know only true for yourself. Okay, so Bunty here has a hidden world. Okay, Bunty has also hidden desires. Tell me if I'm wrong. Okay, Bunty is very freaky about her choosing of friends. She doesn't get along very quickly. If she does, that is for lifetime, right or not? Okay, and Bunty is very, very, very naughty. It's just that the close one gets to know more about you.
Very naughty.
Very naughty, okay. So other than that, did we discuss these things? Okay, so that's all, Bunty. Thank you very much. Okay, this was a little bit personality enhancement, personality cues that usually our local body language. Trainers too, sorry. So we all have gone to that one park or mall or places where we can see astrologers or we could see tarot readers or we could see face readers. But what we never identified that there are so many things that one person can identify from the use of nonverbal communication. They look at your body completely from head to toe. They also look at what you're wearing, how good are you in any of the languages. If you're good at English, Hindi, are you using limited amount of words? You are very verbose, many, many, many words you're speaking, or you're speaking less. You're smiling more, smiling less. So there are a few things I want to talk about today. Before going to all the fortune tellers, please take consider of these problems or these points that I want to talk about. First thing, what they know is nodding. When you're talking to them and they say, okay, I see something like this. And what you do is, so they identify that, okay, now I am with the same page as this man or this woman. So they move forward. The next thing that come into picture is the expression. So we have around 7 universal emotions that we use in day-to-day lives. If I'm expecting something and I'm saying something and I can see a little bit of smile in there, I can pinch on to that thing. If Bunty was here, I do not know anything about Bunty. I just said that, okay, there was a hidden world. Now these statements are known as Barnum statements. We all have been using it for years. Especially when you go to these face readers, fortune tellers, they will never tell you the exact detail. Now how many of you have the hidden world that nobody knows? Everybody has. Okay? Everyone is naughty that nobody knows. We all have done those little things that nobody knows. Nobody will ever be knowing. But fortune teller use the same statements to take you to their advantage. Second thing what they notice is expression. So if you are going, no, then they understand, okay, maybe I'm not going in the right direction. So let us change the language a little bit. So I have to tell, if Bunty, do you use cars? And if she is, then I quickly turn my language into, okay, maybe something related to drive. You love road trips. Everybody road trips. They love road trips. Now, coming to the third point. They look at your body posture. How they will look at it? The way you sit. So if you sit with the body close and sitting at the front, they actually think that you're nervous and you're anxious. And based on that, they will tell you random things about those future predictions. How about this? A person can never tell you your future based on any qualification or any calculation. They will actually note your body language. I'm telling all of this because I've learned tarot reading and my mentor told, body language plays an active and important role. In learning body language, you will be knowing entire tarot reading. You don't have to learn tarot reading as such. If a person is coming to know whether or not I will be having this girlfriend, you can identify by their body language and tell them whether it is a yes or no. Now, most of us, we go to these fortune tellers just for fun, but some take it very seriously. Moving on a little bit, they also look at how open or how receptive you are. So if you're receptive, you will be sitting in a nice posture and you will be smiling and talking. Yes, yes, yes. Very nice. If you're not receptive, they will twist on the conversation to something that you will be receptive to. That is how they can identify if you are there, you are believing what he is saying or she is saying, or you're not. Moving on again a little bit, they will also look at your body and your node. If the node is yes, twice, that's usually an active node. If it is no head node and just looking at them, they know that you're not buying their point. So they will keep on talking to you. So next time, whenever you're going to speak to any of the people, any of the fortune tellers, please identify that they are looking at your body language or they're not looking at your body language. We understand that by, oh, looking at me, they understand so many things. But whenever they are speaking about these statements, always find out if they will be applying to the general public or not. They should be as crisp as 5 years back in Chandigarh in restaurant number so and so, you went with this person. Is it that correct? Then yes, a person should be believed. If it is not, then the person should not be believed. You can go ahead and you can sit with the person, you can talk to them, and you can also identify in what speech rate they are talking. If the speech rate is slow and low, they're actually making you realize that they know a lot of things. For example, just changing the pitch or the voice, I can be a tarot reader and you can understand whatever I'm going to say. It's just that how I talk to you and it's just that how I make you feel. It's just the voice that makes all the impression and the way the person is creating the scenario. Why these astrologers or these fortune tellers, they have this random things wearing. Maybe something on their hands, something on their head, something on their legs. So their different types of dress codes always creates a scene that they know something that you don't. So do not fall for all of that. And when you go to the park or the mall or any public places the next time for a fortune telling, please tell them that, you know, I will do a little bit of fortune telling first and then I can let you do it. Just go for fun. And just check it whether the person is actually doing it for fun, the person is actually knowing all those stuff. And if the person doesn't know, then you can definitely find out what is the reason behind it. By knowing these things, you also can be a fortune teller yourself. You don't have to go to these people. And one thing you have to keep in mind, that these people have regular customers. They don't have new customers. Always your moms, your grandparents, they go to only one pandit or maybe only one person, always. Because they think they will be knowing the exact solution, which obviously they don't have the solution. That's why the person is again going to them. So please keep in mind that it is only your body language from head to toe that gives away all the cues that they will be needing for you to capture you. Other than that, it's not. If the person is speaking to you, all the calculations, please bring it to our government so that he can predict a lot of things. So my last statement will be, whenever you go to these public places, to any of the fortune tellers, please identify yourself as a police and then start talking. Let's see how many murders you have committed. Thanks.